What's up, YouTube? This is for trade company, guys. Today we have a great day on the market, guys. We are coming back again to a crazy, crazy week. We're closing this week with so many bangers out there, guys. So you guys been following yesterday. I gave you guys a watch list today. This one ended up playing on very, very nice, right? The market, even though there are gonna be days that, you know, I choppy like today, right? You guys gotta learn that the money goes somewhere. The money is always gonna be somewhere, right? If it's not on large caps, it's most likely gonna be in penny stocks, right? And you guys know who is building on top of these penny stocks, then you know we are. So if you guys have been, you know, tapping in with this, listening, you know, keeping an eye on this, for the people that has been on this with me, you know, we've been trading LLDX since yesterday, right? I gave you guys LLDX around $3, 380s, 350s, 360s. And of course, those people that are on the Alpha community with me, they have this guidance step by step. And obviously, this is why they are making money, they're paying profitable, they're learning. That's one of the main points here, learning. And then once you learn the strategy, then you're going to be able to become profitable and consistent trader. So again, here in the Alpha community, because those are not in the Alpha community, you might want to be joining up this week. So once again, Sunday, we got the class. And again, we have all the guidance here in Trace. And I'm going to share today why we have another banger. Besides LDX, that ended up going today, new highs, and ended up going to 519, pretty much almost filling the gap up that we had. We still have more opportunities. And yesterday, I actually discussed one of them, right? And it was MGOL, right? Yesterday, even when it was sitting around $3, and I told you exactly why I like it. Because they were set there, the momentum, the, you know, the charts were actually pretty decent in here on the Alpha community. I alerted them to them yesterday that they needed to get some entrances before the breakout. And I'm going to show you guys so you guys can see timestamp it. One is when it happened. So yesterday, as you guys can see here, at 5:52 p.m., right? And this was, I believe, much before I actually dropped the trade, drop the video. I added a 5.05. I told him it was a high risk, but the chart was there, the momentum was there, the risk reward as a trade was there. And you know, it is highly super, super shorter. One of the reasons why I actually like it is because the thin flow that it has, and it's been super, super short. And I still believe this has more to go, right? And that's what I'm gonna touch base here in a minute. But as you guys can see here, ended up paying us pretty good, 505 yesterday overnight, ended up spying. And today, guys, this morning, look what MGL ended up doing today. This morning, we ended up breaking out as high as 6.99. This is the $5 that we've been talking about. It was $3 yesterday in after hours. So opportunities are actually always going to be there, guys. So don't miss out the next trade, guys. You know what to do. If you want to be part of the team, learn, make money, join up, guys. Link is in the description, guys. First comment, join up. I'm gonna wait for you guys here because next week is gonna be another crazy week with another opportunities to make a lot of money. Right? We also trade besides MGOL today. I was able to trade MRIN, which is another stock in particular that I might like for next week. The chart itself is as well has some accumulation, but it cannot break above 260s to 70s. So it might be something that we might want to look for next week in case it wants to break out, right? Still about holding the trend. There are some buyers, but usually you guys know towards the weekend, we ended up seeing the weakness, you know, lack of buyers, and that's totally fine, right? But this setup seems to be setting up for next week, so keep an eye on this one. The same way that NGL is setting up, I started today, I bought some around 630s. I'm still looking to average down because you see the major trend line, it hasn't broke yet. Look at the 30 minute, right? Every single time it comes back tested, it bounces, it comes with a test and it bounces. So I think that we are gonna come back down, probably test it again around 540s, and we might be, you know, gearing for a new breakout. Why am I believing this? Because looking at this daily chart, not only we are actually breaking out the 200, I mean, we're almost, because we went to 699, right? There are bars pretty much increasing on the daily chart, even on the weekly charts. So you can see the last couple of times that, you know, MGL ended up breaking out, ended up going to as high 18, 17, right? And this is on the weekly chart. Probably something going to 769. Now, considering the momentum, considering that we have on the weekend, and again, it's a 6 or 7,000 flow, very, very thin with this momentum in a week, I still believe that we're going to be able to see more of MGL next week. And I'm not really going to check the cost to borrow. You see, it's still high. It's still seeing a 920% cost to borrow. That tells me that is not going anywhere. I think this is not ending. I mean, they believe this is still has more to offer. And again, it's all about, you know, sizing properly, buy the dips, understand what are we trading this, right? Understand the dips might be possible, right? You can see last time, even it can even come back down as low as $5, 505, testing the 20 mil on the hourly, right? If he breaks the 9 EMA. If he doesn't break it, that's fine. But remember, you have to look to major time frames to understand what the stock might be doing. So in this particular case, again, seems to be holding here. Again, I have some position list. We will see if it breaks out or not. But in another one that we've been talking for some amount of time, right? I talk about SGMO, right? Ended up paying a very nice today, guys. We actually added a dip. And again, this is why I have on the community very detail. I told them yesterday that I was buying SGMO yesterday because it was looking for a breakout. So look at this. I'm going to show you guys. So you guys can see timestamp it yesterday at 3:20 hours. SGMO added a 93 cents, right? Because it seems ready for another falling wedge breakout. And this was yesterday, 3:20, guys. Today, when it started breaking out, look what happened. We ended up breaking as $1 plus, almost 1.11 as far as I believe, making us good money. And doesn't matter. I still believe it has more potential. I still believe this stock can go much higher because we have, again, faster bucked it up. Like I said, we look into the major time frames and it's still the chart looking pretty good. Today's bounce show me that bars are strong, right? We haven't broke the 90. We just broke the unit falling wedge. Looking at the weekly chart, you have the bar still stepping in. So this only needs some news and I think it's going to take off, right? But again, that doesn't mean that we can't dip down, right? We've seen it. We have to follow the chart before to follow, the price action that we're going to be able to make a good amount of money. Remember, this needs to stay above $1 because the psychological level is one. So the more they hold above $1, the best is going to be for buyers to step in, okay? Now, obviously, as far as options, guys, we're talking about options all the time. And today, guys, we had a very strong day in a way that the morning was a little choppy, right? You guys need to understand this, that when the market goes like this, you know, usually Fridays, if there is not much trend, you guys can see it was very hard to trade today. You might have quite, you know, some pops here and there, but overall, you gotta understand that there's low liquidity, there are low volume, this moves, and they're gonna be choppy. They're gonna sell out very quick. So if you decide to take a trade when the momentum is like this, right? What is your best bet? Your best bet is pretty much size down. Trade with a less amount of money, right? Limit that risk exposure for you to lose amount of money, right? People come to Fridays and risk a lot of money and of course, end up losing. And that's why I don't want you guys to lose. You guys want to size down and probably, you know, trade with less amount of money, right? I made the mistakes years ago. And that's why Fridays, I ended up losing, trading less, right? Less because I protect my capital. But again, I'm gonna kind of discuss this really quick. SPY, like I said, he hasn't reclaimed the trend. We're still rejecting the 60 MA, so it looks kind of bearish. We might be, you know, again, jitting for a rejection. Next week, we're going to see. I'm going to kind of like let it close the market. I'm going to reassess this on Sunday and Saturday. So don't miss those videos because I'm going to go in depth on those two. Tesla, we had another quiet move as well. But you guys can see, it cannot break the 20 EMA on the 4-hour chart. We're telling you there are still weakness. Right, even though we have a nice run today, at some point, right, because most of part of the morning was still choppy, there was only a decent run around 1 o'clock. Once you bars step in and you pick a pretty good trend, but ideally, like I said, we need to stay above 200. Tesla has been having a hard time today to stay above 200, which tells me there's weakness. Right, we want to see Tesla above 200 in order for buyers to step in. Now there are buyers accumulating here for sure. We can see that not on the volume profile. We can also see on the volume bars. But we need to have confirmation, right? What is confirmation? Breaking above. We do break over 200, we can run. I think we can definitely run, probably see 210s, maybe 214s, tapping that 200 may, if not, right? But if not, the rejection is going to be ugly. And we might see some downside. But we're going to have to see how that plays out next week. And again, all these guys, not only we have stocks, but also we get option levels. I share my levels with my, you know, SPY, Tesla, Nvidia, on the Alpha community, which is only here, right? So once again, guys, if you want to be part of the team, join up. Link is in the description, guys. First comment. I'm going to win for you guys. You know, we're making a lot of money. You want to learn, trade, having a proper strategy. This is where you want to be, right? But now that I kind of talk really quick on Nvidia. Nvidia today was a really, really bad price action. Today, actually, I pretty much avoid Nvidia the most because you guys can see what we talk about, right? One, there is no trend. If the stocks are trading between the EMAs, that tells you that there's no trend. So if there is small pops, small, you know, pops and drops, they're not sustainable, right? Means that they're going to reverse quick, right? And that's what you can see. Once it pops, it rejects. Once it actually breaks down, it bounces immediately. So the trades are a bit of risk reward here. Not worth it against, you know, to take that risk. Learn to, you know, when to trade, learn when to not trade, Remember, you know, we are traders here. We don't wanna stay too long on the trades. We only have to take part of the moves. Once we see green, we take green and we move on to the next one, okay? But other than that, guys, Nvidia has been pretty like today. It hasn't done much. It's still rejecting the 60 MA, as you guys can see here. So we're still in a bearish territory towards next week, right? And then I'm gonna discuss a really quick a stock that I do like. And I actually had a pop today. I just wanna put it in your radar, guys, so you can make them some homework. Is GMM, sorry. The reason I like this one is because not only the chart historically, it shows that it has big pops. You see, last time it went from like 90 cents to 1.88, even from 86 to like 1.30. Now it's just accumulating volume and it seems to be ready for another breakout. Today only had a baby pop, right? Ended up having like a probably 112 and just reacted really quick. And that's totally fine to me because we only got it started today. It's only 12 million fold stock. And what I personally like on this is that I actually found out a couple of very interesting things here. Not too long ago, the CEO, right? This is actually a big flag, right? So if this big flag breaks out, right, breaks that flag, this we have pretty much first stop 130s, and then we can even see 180s. This is the flag that I'm looking on the main time frame, but it's highly cost to borrow. It's 267%, which is good, right? In a way that, you know, they're not high as the cost to borrow. It means that, you know, the shorts need to pay more for their shares. Now, what I actually mean, like, about is the fact that the CEO, he went to have a talk, you know, with some, let me put it here, engaged with industry leaders. And I was just reading this, and you see that, you know, this CEO, they were actually interacting with the CEO, with Nvidia CEO and Meta CEO, Mark. So we have Nvidia and Meta involved on this company. So I'm expecting any PR or anything related to them, any news coming, I think this is going to pop. Because you guys know how big is Nvidia is, how big Meta is, and the CEO of GMM is involved with them. It's getting involved with it, right? So again, it's just sooner or later that we see anything related with any partnership, anything that is going to make the stock pop. Again, considering that how beat down it is, right? It's just he's always the CEO is looking for, you know, good growth. Now, looking on the past, they actually report pretty interesting earnings, right? Latest earnings that they have. The report is from 9.8 million increase in the net income for the past 6 months, which is not even bad because they're still profitable. They're still making some money, which is good, right? So we will see if they actually this maintain this, but the growth on this one seems to be pretty okay. Again, I'm looking for a decent pop, right? I mean, this with how volatile it is, this can easily go, you know, 100% from what it is right now, considering, you know, where it's sitting and how it's actually shaping up. Okay, guys. But again, this is homework for you guys. Make some homework for the weekend. Again, I'm gonna keep an eye on MGL. And still, because again, even though we might be in deep in the zone, I'm still believe this has more to offer as how this daily is start shaping it once again, guys. Okay, guys. So be safe. Any questions, please let me know. Shoot me a DM. Like if you guys are making some money with this trade, with this setups, don't forget, guys, like and subscribe, share the community, and again, join to the community as well. You know, I'm gonna be waiting for you guys. And again, I hope you guys have a great weekend. Don't forget to journal your trade, guys. We all make mistakes. But there is nothing better to learn from those losses. Okay, guys, so be safe, take care, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.